Hello and welcome to the episode 75 of What A Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Some stories from today include two Cavern special dates, a BBC radio session, and a continuation of John and Yoko's quest to get married. On the 16th of March 1961, the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, played their lunchtime gig at the Cavern Club in Liverpool for their 10th overall performance in that venue. Fast forward 1 year, and in 1962, we have performance number 60 at the Cavern for the Beatles. The lads, still with Pete Best on drums, performed an evening concert in support to Pete Haslam's Collegians. In 1963, the Beatles were at the Studio 3A of the London headquarters of BBC Radio to perform 6 songs live. I Saw Her Standing There, Misery, Too Much Monkey Business, I'm Talking About You, Please Please Me, and The Hippie Hippie Shake. The songs were broadcast between 10 a.m. and 12 noon with regular programming. Only Too Much Monkey Business was aired abroad by the General Overseas Service, which broadcasted normal BBC radio programs in shortwaves across several continents. The studio date was in substitution for an 11th of March Saturday Club session for the BBC, which the soon-to-be Fab Four were forced to cancel due to John Lennon's illness. At the end of their performance, the band travelled north 158 miles, about 255 kilometers, to join their package tour with Montez and Rowe for 2 gigs at the City Hall in Sheffield. As it had happened for the 13th of March stop in York, featured in episode 72 of What A Fab Day, this was the second time the Beatles performed in the same venue in less than a month. The previous occasion had been the 2nd of March stop for the Helen Shapiro package tour, featured in episode 61 of this podcast. Talking about this podcast, do you think I'm doing a good job? Would you like for me to do an even better one? Then, by all means, spread the news about its existence to your friends via social media or good old word of mouth. And please visit www.simonmas.com/support to find out other ways in which you can be fab and help me out. If instead you think something here could use a bit more love, please drop me a line. I love to hear from you and I love to get better at what I'm doing. Thank you! On the 16th of March 1964, after a weekend of rest, Ringo Starr was at the Twickenham Film Studios to film the canteen scene in which actor Wilfred Bramble persuades him to desert the rest of the band, starting the so-called solo sequence of the film. The other Beatles had effectively a day off. George Harrison accompanied Brian Epstein at a Cilla Black session for BBC's Saturday Club. Meanwhile, back in the United States, the Beatles' new single, Can't Buy Me Love, was released by Capitol Records. I don't usually talk about non-UK releases, but this is a special occasion. The record would go on to sell more than 2 million copies in the first week, an unprecedented achievement on the American single market. In 1965, there's more filming to do, this time on the Austrian Alps, with the Beatles and their doubles completing the filming of the sequence on the snowy slopes for the band's forthcoming second feature flicks, still without a title at the time. In 1969, while Paul and Linda McCartney were flying from London to New York on their honeymoon and on a visit to her relatives for a couple of weeks, another couple was trying to tie the knot. Unable to get married on a ferry to France, John Lennon and Yoko Ono decided instead to fly to Paris, checking in at the Plaza Athénée, lured by the mirage of less bureaucracy to get married in France. Again, no such luck. On their arrival, Apple employee Peter Brown informed them that they needed to live in France for at least 2 weeks to get a permission to marry there. John and Yoko were told that perhaps the best option was to fly to Gibraltar, a British protectorate, and marry there. The matter started as a whimsical idea, perhaps inspired by Paul and Linda's wedding, had started to become a bit of a burden, so much so that John later wrote the Ballad of John and Yoko about the whole affair and other bits of life with Yoko at the time. In 1970, Paul McCartney, still using his Billy Martin pseudonym, returned to the EMI studios between 6:30 and 8 p.m. for a playback of Oh You, recorded and mixed previously in a session at the Morgan Studios. Nothing else was recorded or mixed today. This concludes this episode of What a Fab Day. In the episode description, you'll find the usual link to the support page and to the bibliography of the podcast, with lots and lots of Amazon affiliate links for your Beatles shopping needs. What stories will tomorrow bring us? Tune in to find out. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.